Right. The thing is, and you girls out there will understand, that us steps girls, well, when we want a night out, we like to climb ourselves up, don't we?
Absolutely. It makes you feel special.
Yeah. No, you are so right. If you can't make a bit of an effort, then what is the world coming to? Now take our Faye, for example. She always looks a treat when she goes for the big
one. Oh, she does look a treat.
Cheers, girls.
And the lads, they just don't understand, do they?
Well, men don't, do they?
No, they think that we take hours to get ready. But it doesn't look this good in a couple of minutes, does it?
No, it's all in the preparation.
So, how do you get yourself looking so good, Faye?
You know, I've been asked that so many times before.
I bet you have.
Well, I'll let you into a little secret. If you're preparing for a big night out, this is what you do.
Gold, it's stuck!
So here I am in the centre of London, overlooking Hyde Park, and we're actually staying in the Hilton Hotel Park Lane, where I used to feature as a singer upstairs. Now if you come through my gorgeous suite, what we'll do is we'll show you some top tips on makeup. First of all, before anything, make sure you've got a clean face. And then we're going to go for the foundation and the concealer. I get my makeup sponge wet and we spray it with a bit of water, make it nice and moist. Use your hand as your palette and then get a nice even spread on the sponge and start putting it on. First on the nose to keep it central and then spread it out from there. Then a liquid concealer is best, and what you do, because you need it nice and light, I use a brush, and then if you've got darker circles underneath your eyes, which is a common one, you just gently brush it on under your eyes and smooth it out, and then you look 10 years younger straight away. So next thing I do is I get my powder, and it can be either pressed or loose, but I loosen it up with a nice feathery brush like this, and then you can just gently brush it all over your face so you have a nice matte finish. Next I'm going to go for the eyes. I'm going to use my favourite eyeshadow, which is this one. You can see it's gone down, and I'm just going to start off with a base colour on my eyelid here. Put it all over your eye and then just underneath your brow. It's very shiny. Right, so now we've got our base colour on, what I'm going to do is add a bit more colour, and I'm just going to go for a bit more of a beigey brown colour here. So, and just add it underneath the brow, like so, around your natural socket. Put this colour down and use my old faithful here. And it's a beautiful dark brown, almost chocolate. And we're going to do the same again, but concentrate on the socket area immediately in the middle. I'm just going to go around here gently. And after that, you can see your eyes opening out. And then I'm going to take it down halfway across my eyelid here as well. I should have a big eye now. Just to finish off the eyes, I'm going to use eyeliner and mascara. I'm going to use my own little mirror here, because it's close-up work, and I'm going to take it right from the corner of my eye and take it all the way across. It took me years of practice to do this, so you might have to try it once or twice before you get it perfect. And take it right across my eye, and because I like having massive eyes, I'm going to extend it past my real eyelid, and I'm just going to look down and drag it straight across. Okay, so this is another case of close-up work, so I'm going to grab my little mirror again. And what I do is I open my eye fully, and not too close to your eye, but from as low as possible, and then drag it up your eyelashes like so. You can change the shape of your face completely by using blusher. So if you want cheekbones, usually to go underneath your natural cheekbone, there, we'll show your cheek a bit more there and give you lots of shape in your face, which I like doing. So I'm going to slap on a bit like that. Nice circular movements, also a little bit on the front of your cheek, just to give you a nice bit of colour. We're going to go down here and grab a nice lip liner. I'm not going to be able to speak very well, so I'm just going to do this one quickly. Look around. Normal shape of your lips. Quickly down it. Edges. Give yourself a nice clean line and get ready to plaster on your lipstick. Nice chocolatey brown like my makeup. And then I've got a nice shiny sort of goldy pale colour there. So if I put the dark one on first, I'm going to stick this on quickly on there. Nice and evenly, and the bottom one. That's a bit too dark for me. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick on the other one on the bottom. This is mine, so I can do this. Nice shiny lips too. Steps girls are mad on glitter. So as we're going for the brownie gold look thing, we're going to go for some gold glitter. We're going to use our hand again as your palette, so you don't squidge it all over your face and make a mess. And I'm going to start off putting nice little lumps at the edge of my eye, like that. Okay. It's very nice and sparkly. We're going to take it even further down the eye, just to give it a much more dramatic effect. Take it right underneath your lashes. Careful of your eyes. And then you have this sparkly look. So after all that, even more accessories we can use are bindis, my personal favourite. And we've got a lovely one here. The best thing to use as adhesive, or the most available sort of glue, is eyelash glue. I put it all over the back, and then just quickly stick it in the middle. Scare it up. Do that way. And there you go. Okay. So that's me done. My makeup is all finished. Now I need to nip into my party wear and show you the last and final touch. The glitter tattoo. I need to damp it and make it completely wet. And then we just hold that there for 30 seconds. And dump it here. So that's it, I'm all done and I'm ready to go party. See ya!